वेलकम टू कौटिल्या पर्सपेक्टिव्स इन एडुकेशन टॉपिक इज पर्सपेक्टिव्स इन एडुकेशन बिफोर गोइंग इनटू द सब्जेक्ट लेट अस हैव अ ग्लांस एट एडुकेशन एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एंड द स्टेट ऑफ एडुकेशन इन एंशिएंट इंडिया मिडिवल इंडिया एंड मॉडर्न इंडिया ब्रीफली वी कैन कॉल इट एज हिस्ट्री ऑफ एडुकेशन इन इंडिया ब्रीफली वी कैन कॉल द सब टॉपिक एज हिस्ट्री ऑफ एडुकेशन इन इंडिया एंशिएंट education system. Let us begin with ancient education. What is called ancient education? Vedic education, Jainist education, Buddhist education, we call it as ancient education. Vedic education is the earliest one. Vedic life is divided into two phases, Rigvedic period and post-Vedic period. The period from 1500 BC to 1000 years BC should be called as Rigvedic period. The period from 1000 years BC to 600 years BC is called post-Vedic period. We can call it as early Vedic period. Rigvedic period can also be called as early Vedic period, and post-Vedic period can also be called as later Vedic period. Okay, the word Veda has been derived from the root word with. The word Veda has been derived from the root word with. With means to know. Simply, we can call Veda as knowledge. Which type of knowledge it is? Knowledge related to religion, knowledge related to spirituality, spiritual knowledge, religious knowledge. Knowledge related to religion, knowledge related to spirituality. What are the objectives of Vedic education? Objectives of Vedic education. Vedic education. Objectives of Vedic education. First one, unraveling. Unraveling soul. Next one, salvation or moksha. Third one, character building. Character building. Next one, moral development. Moral development. Next one, all-round development. So these are the general objectives of Vedic education. What is the ultimate objective of Vedic education? Moksha or salvation. Getting salvation is the ultimate objective, ultimate aim of Vedic education. Okay. And Vedic education, it starts with Upanayana. So generally speaking, the Vedic tradition divides the human life into four stages, into four ashramas. The Vedic tradition divides the human life into four ashramas. What are they? Brahmacharya, Gruhastha, Vanaprastha, Sanyasashrama. Brahmacharya means student life. Gruhastha means the life of householder. Vanaprastha means partial retirement. Partial retirement should be called Vanaprastha. Complete retirement is called Sannyasi. So like that, the Vedic tradition divides the human life into four stages or four ashramas. Brahmacharya ashrama is the student life. Student life in Vedic education begins with a samskara, a ceremony, namely Upanayana. Upanayana samskara is the beginning of Vedic education. Is the beginning of Vedic education. Upanayana samskara is the beginning of Vedic education. In early Vedic period or Rigvedic period, all sections of people in the society were allowed to pursue the education. They had access to education. Whereas in post-Vedic period, Varna system got deeply entrenched, caste system got deeply established in society, and it never allowed the lowest caste, Shudra, to pursue education. And several restrictions were imposed on women education also during post-Vedic period. So that's why you can say that there are some differences between early Vedic education and later Vedic education. Okay. Let us talk about Upanayana, Upanayana Samskara, sacred thread ceremony, the beginning of Vedic education. For Brahmins, 8 years is a boy, a Brahmin boy at the age of 8 years is entitled to Upanayana. For Kshatriya boy, 10 years of age, if he is 10 years old boy, then he is eligible to Upanayana. For Vaishya boy, 12 years. Okay. And after attaining the age of 18, okay, so the education, Vedic education, is stated to have been completed. That means total period of Vedic education around 12 years. After the boy attains the age of 18 years, the Vedic education is stated to have been completed. So with a festival that is called Samavartanotsavam, final festival, Samavartanotsavam. Convocation like festival, Samavartanotsavam. Okay. Let us talk about the curriculum of Vedic education. The curriculum of Vedic education. I told you already the curriculum of Vedic education is having great association with religious ideas as well as spiritual ideas. Then what are the topics in that curriculum? Here see, Vedas, Brahmanas, Aranyakas, Upanishad, Vedangas, etc. Let us talk about Vedas. There are four Vedas, Chaturvedas. First one is Rigveda, oldest Veda, Rigveda. What is the general meaning of Rigveda? Literally, Rigveda, the word implies Veda of praise. The word implies Veda of praise. Rigveda is divided into 10 mandalas. Rigveda is divided into 10 mandalas. Second to 7 mandalas were composed by some families of sages. That's why these mandalas are called family books. Who are they actually? Who composed the mandalas from 2nd to 7th? The Rigvedic rishis like Atri Mahamuni, Bharadwaja, Vasishtha, Vishwamitra. These are the sages of Rigvedic period who are stated to have composed the mandalas from 2nd to 7th. Famous Gayatri Mantra was there in 3rd mandala of Rigveda, which was composed by Vishwamitra. And there are totally 1017 hymns are there in Rigveda, later supplemented by 11, totally 1028 hymns divided into 10 mandalas. So that is the basic information about Rigveda. Let us talk about Samaveda, a part of Vedic curriculum. Samaveda. The word Samaveda has been derived from the root word Saman. Saman means melody or song. So it itself is indicative of certain thing. What is that? The earliest traces of Indian musical tradition related to Samaveda. Yajurveda. What is meant by Yajur? Yajur means formulae. It's a formulae dealing with performing yagnas and yagas. Yagnas and yagas. There are two kinds in Yajurveda. Krishna Yajurveda and Shukla Yajurveda. Krishna Yajurveda deals with non-Aryan rituals. Shukla Yajurveda deals with Aryan rituals. We can call Krishna Yajurveda as Black Yajurveda also. We can call Shukla Yajurveda as White Yajurveda. So Krishna Yajurveda dealing with non-Aryan ritualism, Shukla Yajurveda or White Yajurveda, it deals with Aryan ritualism. And Krishna Yajurveda, it contains both hymns as well as prose commentaries also. Whereas Shukla Yajurveda contains only hymns, no prose commentaries. And let us talk about Atharvana Veda. Atharvan. The word Atharvan, it implies formulae regarding magical spell and chants, mantras and tantras. Atharvana Veda deals with non-Aryan beliefs. Non-Aryan beliefs. That's why Aryans, they were reluctant to provide the status of Veda for a long time to Atharvana Veda. Recently only it was accorded the status of Veda. Let us talk about Vedangas, a part of Vedic curriculum. Vedangas. There are six Vedangas. First one, Siksha. Siksha means phonetics, pronunciation. Chandas. Chandas means level of sound, pitch of sound. Metrics, we can call it as metrics. Vyakarana. Vyakarana means grammar. Nirukta. Nirukta means vocabulary, etymology. Rather, etymology. Exact word is etymology. Etymology. Vocabulary or etymology. Okay. Khagola, war or Jyotisha. Both one and the same. Astronomy or astrology. And last one, Kalpa. These are all called Vedangas. So, these are all the part and parcel of Vedic curriculum. Vedic curriculum deals with religious things as well as spiritual things.